Now we have to find balancing length for cell E2 with the similar procedure. We have to find the balancing length of cell E2, and for that purpose, first of all, disconnect this plug key. Then move this key to the other plug key. In this way, what happens that this cell, which is E1, it is out of the circuit, and this cell, which is E2, it is included in the circuit. Now we have to do the same thing. Place this jockey at the fourth wire, and then at the third wire, and again we can see that the balancing point is in between these two wires. So we have to find the balancing point again with the same procedure, that I will move this jockey step by step on this wire. Now here you can see that the balancing point for cell E2, it lies on this fourth wire. So we have to find out the reading. So that we will find again with the help of the scale. And here you can see that the scale points 97. Now again, the reading is not 97. Here you have to see that 1, 2, 3, and the balancing point lies at the fourth wire. Now the readings which we have observed here, the length of L1 and length of L2, we have written in our table. Now these are the actual values. You can see here that the balancing length for cell E1, L1, that is 284.5 centimeters. Then balancing length for cell E2, which is L2, it is 298.5 centimeters. Now, putting these values, all these three values in this formula, we have found out that the value of E2, that is EMF of the cell E2, it is 1.33 volts. This is one set of observation. We have to take two more observations by slightly changing the position of rheostat for each observation. After that, we have to take mean EMF of the cell E2. Like, we will have three values here of E2. We'll take mean of these three values, and that will be the end result, that mean value of cell E2. And here we have seen that it is 1.34 volts. Now, in the end, let me tell you one thing, that there are a few points which you have to remember. While when you have to take L1, that is the balancing length for the cell E1, the points which we have to remember is that your key K, which is this plug key, it should be on. Then K1, this is K1, this K1, it should be on. When this K1 is on, it means that this cell E1 is included in our circuit, and K2 should be off. This is the condition for finding balancing length L1. Then, for the second line, when we have to find L2, this key, which is the plug key, this should be on. K1, it should be off. This means that this, we have to open this key. By opening it, it means that this cell E1, it is out of the circuit, and when we insert the plug key here, or in other words, when we turn on K2, we are including cell E2 in the circuit. So this is the condition for finding balancing length L2. These are the two points which we have to remember in order to find L1 and L2. Now, dear students, I'll tell you the method how to peel the wire, with the help of which we will peel off this wire. Here you can see that the wire is not peeled. So this slot, this one is the last one, it is a wrong one. Here you can see it is loose. Second one is also loose. So we will place in the third slot and we will just put a normal pressure and we will press it. And by pressing it, it will just peel off the wire. Now we need some more, so I'll So this is the way how to peel our wires. Now after that, for checking the connections, that the connections, they should be tight. I'll tell you the right way how we can make the connections. To make the connection with this type of wire, which here you can see that it is not properly peeled. So if you make connections with this type of wire, your connections will not be correct. Like, see, it will not go in this screw, and afterwards what will happen, that it can slide, it can come out. So this is the wrong way. So you have to peel your wire more with the help of that. Peel your wire more with the help of this cutter. Then fold this wire like this and tighten your screw. And this way you can see that this wire, it is tightly screwed up and it will not come out easily.
You can take this objective physics practicals from Ilmi Book Depot, Urdu Bazaar Lahore, or you can download directly from my website. Your readings may be different from these readings. Check these readings as a reference. Thank you.